But now I'm going to ask, since we've talked about Sheilo and his own publicity stunt, which he came out to say was not real. No divorce is happening. All thanks to God for that.
And he has gone ahead to delete the posts.
What's up with Tubaba? Because it happens, it just happened today.
Yeah.
And the kind of words Madam Annie is posting about wasted time on her own page. And his apology.
Actually, this one is not publicity stunt. This
Why
one is
do you
real.
Say so?
Because of if you read the messages, I don't think Two-Face would want to do something Sheila just did. And it's somehow is unprofessional. You wouldn't want to do that. It's not tactically, it's not sound if you do that.
Okay.
So I feel this one is real and
maybe we should actually read the tweets. He says, I'm sorry that I have, of course, he used words that cannot be used on TV.
Yeah.
I'm sorry that I have messed up, I'd say so much. I have messed up as a role model, as a father, and as a husband. Annie, I'm sorry. I know you tried your best. Annie, you have been my pillar. Ife, you have been a wonderful manager and IG bro. My fans would have... I don't understand what that means. And after he put that up, people started going to Annie's page, of course, to go and check. And Annie put up her photo, and she put up a post where she was saying, 4 million plus friends. Thank you. My heart is filled with gratitude. Who I be? Thank you for supporting all that I do, for loving me truly. You guys made the Annie Idibia brand a success. I want to shake every single one of you people that inspired me and the people that criticized me constructively. Blessings upon you. Enough respect to every single lover here. We are in this together forever. I just want to celebrate you and say a big thank you to you. I love you. It's something to tickle you. A little bit is coming soon. Hashtag Iwariwo. So some people are saying
Iwariwo doesn't sound nice. Iwariwo sounds like trouble.
No.
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 That means you don't understand Igbo.
Are you Igbo?
The sound.
Jehovah Mekwara.
Iwariwo is like an exclamation of joy.
Yeah.
So to speak.
And the way the Iwariwo, like something's coming to attack you.
You think they said Iwariwo? Okay. So,
no, but that's
they said even in Yoruba, Iwariwo is not trouble. But now this thing is making people, because of what she did, it's making some people think that, you know, is a publicity stunt. So maybe we should...
No, no. The words he used, he said, I have failed as a father. I have failed as a husband. I have failed my fans. Those are strong words. You don't just use that and you come out and say it's publicity stunts. Words are powerful. You don't throw it out that way.
And for somebody like Two-Face, who we've never had this kind of record as in concerning making a post like that.
All right. Yeah, yeah. It's a private... He keeps his things private.
Yeah,
and
so...
Rumors have it that it might be, you know... Infidelity,
something else has happened.
You know, those kind of history we have around
Another
Two-Face.
Issue has
but let's wait while the story unfolds.
Maybe we should actually open up the phone line. So let us know if you want to be a part of the conversation for a few minutes. We'd allow you to call in and be a part of this conversation. You can decide to weigh in on any of the topics. The one of Sheilo, how far is too far with publicity stunts? Do you think that he went too far? Is it something that he shouldn't have done? Or is it just something that Nigerians should actually chill about? He's a comedian and can joke about almost anything. And also with regards to Two-Face and his cryptic messages on Twitter, do you think that is something we should be worried about, or it's just another publicity stunt? The numbers to call are on your screen. Please calling. We'll be closing the segment very soon. My worry with things like this is... I don't have a problem with publicity stunts. Do what you have to do to get your business out there, to get people talking. But my worry is just like the story of the person who cried wolf. At the end of the day,
exactly.
When there's actually a real problem,
people
will not know. They'll just think it's a publicity stunt and it was just misbehaving. Classic case, Harry Songs. Harry Songs came on social media and he put out this post. Thankfully, people were not being insensitive. They saw between the lines that this cryptic message looks like there's trouble in the land. And of course, we had Harry Songs here who shared his journey and how he was dealing with mental issues. Not like, you know, he's not... he had issues he was dealing. He was
with
depressed.
Depression, yeah.
And he had to go see... he had to go get help.
Yes. Yeah.
So the thing is, we don't even know now when they're joking and when they're serious.
And one of the issues I have with this is social media is now so intoxicated to the extent that celebs and everybody feels you need to come out and tell us things about your private life. Sincerely, if you're a celebrity on social media or you're a celebrity in real life, people don't really care about you. They might care about your art, they might love your music, they might love your comedy. In the real sense, don't mistake those followers for love. They don't really, most of them don't really love you, they don't care. So that is why you need to watch and look in between the line. They don't really care. So coming out to always tell us about your private life, if truly Two-Face, there's an issue in his marriage that he needs to clear, you should clear it privately. You don't just come out. You don't owe anybody any explanation.
All right, we have a caller from Lagos, and we will take that. Hello, Funcho.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Please go ahead. Funcho, please turn down the volume of your TV set so that we can hear you properly. We can hear each other. Please turn down the volume of your TV set.
Publicity stunt is getting too much now.
Okay.
I think it's one of the defects of this social media. That's just it. For someone just to be putting rubbish on his marriage, it takes a lot of the personality of that very person. And I just believe that nothing at all is worth doing well.
Okay.
Since there is a man to pray, there is also a God to answer. Mm-hmm. Whatever may be wrong with your marriage, tell it to God. And control which only bring a circle to that your marriage. Instead of publicizing it with outside words. How many people are even interested in your marriage? Who are not even happy about concerning your marriage. So, but I just believe those celebrities. Like Two-Face and Shizong, they know what they are up to. Give me something, I give you something in return. As they study on your audience, I don't believe they know what they are aiming at.
Thank you so much for joining us, Funcho. I didn't get to the end of what he was saying. I know he was talking about Two-Face. I understand that he said that Sheila desecrated his marriage by doing what he did.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I didn't quite hear. Did anybody
say trying to
say
something about Two-Face that people don't really care about your marriage? They don't really care that much. So you don't come out. Just reiterated what I said.
Letting the news out was no point to him.
Yeah, you reiterated what I said.
But can I play devil's advocate? I find that social media has become a thing. Our parents didn't have to battle the devil of social media in their generation.
Yeah.
In our generation, it has become a thing. Unfortunately, people are in a relationship and talk to social media much more than they talk to each other. They're in the room, they're pressing their phones. And I'm sure that addiction to social media should, if it hasn't already become a mental health issue.
Yeah,
you know?
It's
But
extent,
at the end of
yeah.
the day, I'm finding that sometimes you don't blame these people. There's just this part of you that wants to talk to somebody. You know, and sometimes at that moment when you're sad, you're depressed, you're not really thinking.
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing you should do is throw away your phone, because being with your phone has a tendency to make you want to put out stuff you shouldn't put out. So this is me speaking on behalf of celebrities who put their business on social media. It's not easy.
Personally, I feel it can be controlled. I understand the
fact
that...
Are you in their shoes?
I am in their shoes to an extent, so I understand what I'm saying.
yes,
now, we all have our private life and we know what we've faced.
True.
Sometimes, you know, the heat comes and you feel, okay, let me just put it out there, but you control yourself. It's
have
your private life.
Have you never felt a certain type of way and updated it on your status?
Yeah,
never.
I won't say no, I've not done
so
that.
What
but
is
when
the
it comes concerning
that
relationship,
and...
I've never done that.
But at the end of the day, all of us react. We all have different emotions. Esther, what do you think about
it? The thing is, I do not want to have to just let out stuff. But this is one thing I have learned.
Mm-hmm.
Once, as a very young person, my late teenage years, I made a post. It was just the one statement saying, I hate this feeling. Somebody. Immediately, I had people calling me and asking, who was the person?
What happened? Who broke your
what
heart?
Happened? And the feeling in question was not even relating to a man.
Mm.
I was going through something else.
Yeah.
Now, the thing is, when you let out stuff, sometimes you're going to hear statements that you would have hoped before you typed whatever you wanted to type that would give you succor, like Funcho said.
Yeah.
But then it turns out, because by the time you sit down and think about it, you're in another terrible place.
Exactly. Let me shock you. I was chatting with a friend a few days back. She posted something and she was like, she tried to see her pastor on Sunday and she couldn't, a general overseer of their church, a big pastor at that. And the next day, fortunately for her, she was walking past somewhere around the church and the pastor called her close and said, do you know you're going to be great in life? Instead of her to claim it, accept it, and walk towards it, the first thing she would do was to come narrate the story on social media, on Facebook for that matter. And you know, Facebook is different from Instagram. Instagram, you just make new friends. Facebook, people that know from generation to generation. No, your fourth and fifth generation, they are on Facebook. You know Facebook now? She posted it on Facebook. And I called her and I told her, you keep things like this private. Can't you just keep it? She couldn't because era of social media. And it's crazy. We need to work on it.
Now, these are some of the problems that our generation faced, the problems that our parents did not face, problems of learning where to draw the line between what you share on social media and what you share with your with God or your religious leaders, or what you share with a counselor. We cannot underestimate the importance of getting counseling. We do hope that this is not some sort of publicity stunt, and that we hope at the end of the day as well that Two Face and Annie do not have any issues. We don't want to hear any issues with, you know, we love love. All right, let's take one more call before we leave. Hello, Dennis. Good afternoon. Good evening, rather.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Thanks for calling.
Welcome.
Thank you.
All right, please go ahead.
Yes, please. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
We can hear you.
One of the problems this celebrity has, do have, is that I doubt if they go for marriage counseling. Hello?
We can hear you. Go ahead.
And the place of understand that the institution the devil is always interested in is marriage. The devil is moving all about, moving everywhere to see how the marriages function. Between them, mostly celebrities. If you have, we put it on statistics, that most marriages doesn't last beyond 1 year, 2 years. Take a total statistics of the entire Nigerian musicians or the celebrities we have. You can do your statistics, do your checkup, and see how many of them, the marriage is still stick together. You understand?
Yeah, we do.
And not until they are told that the devil is interested in marriage as an institution, they will start posting all this nonsense. Absolute nonsense. Now, all this thing has gone viral. And it's not the topic of the day. I doubt how it's going to retrieve all this. It's like egg that is broken. Can you retrieve all this?
No.
Well, you cannot. There should be one.
All right. Thank you so much, Dennis, for calling. And he did make a lot of sense. Words are like arrows. You know, once you release them, they can't come back to you. Like an egg. Once you break them, it can never be whole again.
I want to disagree a little, which I know I'm not supposed to, but I would like to
say... No, you should. It's okay.
Okay, I want to disagree with him where he said we should look at the statistics of entertainers. We don't have that stat. And when it comes to divorce, as from entertainers' angle, it's not different from the divorce we have in our society in Nigeria right now. Divorce is high. The divorce rate in Nigeria is high. Now, it's not about entertainers. True. Why we hear most about the entertainers' circle is because they are popular.
They're popular.
Uh-huh. If you go to the marriage registry right now, the number of divorces that happens in a day is almost equaling the number of marriages that happen in a day. So we don't have that stat, so we can't state that categorically.
Okay, but there's something also that he said that makes a lot of sense with regards to premarital counseling. Now, whether you're Christian or not, everybody who wants to get married should actually get counseling, whether from your church
definitely.
Or from a professional relationship counselor, because there are some things you don't envisage. Some people go into marriage thinking, oh, it's a bed of roses, and they have very, you know, butterfly. I'm going to wake up in the morning, he will bring me breakfast in bed. I'm just going to be feeling on top of the world.
Why are you sounding like this is what you've been thinking
because
about?
Because I have been thinking, I've thought about this as well.
Only for
and
you
my
to...
friends had called me to say, Auntie, you are deceiving yourself.
Only
this
for
is
you
not
to get married.
Marriage.
I will say, the day.
No, I'm not.
No, but the thing is, I agree with Olive because I remember a certain lady who went through marriage counseling in church, and it was from then, I think the counselor, who is the pastor, asked a question, and the guy reacted in a way that...
What question was that?
I don't know, but he had this anger fist that he struggled to control in front of the counselor, and he just looked at the lady and said, my sister, this is somebody that might throw you slap. Then you talk to him anyhow. Think about it.
Exactly. So counseling will reveal some of the problems that are in marriages. Well, our thoughts and our prayers are with Sheila and family, as well as Annie Idibia and family, and any other family that is going through some form of challenge or the other, most especially as we are in the season of love and it's Valentine in a few days.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.